Do the tight. Do the tight. You the type of boy just to say you had it, huh?
The kicker Graham Gano set to put his foot into this one, and we are underway from downtown Minneapolis.
Man, I'm sick. They lost Dalvin, man. Them niggas out of pocket. Campaign. It's the rematch from the playoffs and shit. They upset the Vikings and shit. That's how they played us.
First play and a first pass for Cousins.
Oh, okay. We gotta check that. What the fuck is that?
I think this is the script they had in mind for their opening drive. This is third and long.
I don't know, none of these linebackers.
Well, that's into a sea of bodies and it's intercepted. And the return here is stopped at the 35-yard line.
Trish is yours, nigga.
Cousins. Looking left side of his guy.
That's Osborne. His first catch of the game, good for 11 and a first down.
I think he has to be saying to himself, how did that not wind up a touchdown? Remember, you just need the tip of the ball across the plane. It's not going to get there, but they're going to be set up in great shape with first and goal.
They need about the length of the football here on first and goal. Madison will score. Touchdown Vikings.
Sometimes offense can get too cute down in the middle, but there's nothing fancy about this one. As Coach Lombardi would say, we get a seal here, and we get a seal here, and we run this play in the alley. And that's good work, did the whole arm, and finish in the end zone.
Joseph connects on the extra point, and that makes the score 7-0. Now Joseph tees it up to kick off following the touchdown. And from his end zone, here's Gary Brightwell. And that decision to bring it out, it's up not being a good one. Cost him about 5 yards as he's tackled at the 20. Offense at the line, ready to begin their next drive. They threw an interception the first time they had the football, wound up leading to a touchdown the other way. How do you approach drive number two?
Going back to your game plan coming in, everyone has matchups that they like better than others, where they think they have an advantage. Dial up some of those plays, try and go to those spots and get your offense moving.
From the 37.
Jones with dang, big boy.
And this winds up a gain of 4 to the 41.
Well, if you're a football guy, that's a pretty run because everyone is in sync right there. Obviously, the guy carrying the ball, but how about the people up front? Leverage, athleticism, they create some nice space for him.
Now Jones. Hit as he throws there, incomplete.
That was their first third down try of the game, and clearly something was off in the execution of that.
Oh, where the fuck my phone at?
They got a whole game left to clean that up and start clicking on those key third down throws.
The offense is not leaving the field. They're going to stay out and go for it on fourth and three. They're indeed going for it as they look to throw. And it's
what you want? You want some dope with some crack, nigga?
So, interesting call there to go for it. And the Vikings, they have the football now in excellent field position. Quickly to Addison here. And he got blown up. Losing yardage on the play back at the 44. That one unable to develop, never got going. A loss of a couple, and it's second down. From the gun, here's Cousins. This one brought in by Jefferson. It'll go as a gain of four. And third and eight now. They'll be in search of 8 yards here as they hope to convert the first down.
On third down, Cousins.
He has his target. It's Addison. And he will have the Vikings first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. After one, 7-0 on EA Sports.
Girl. Tell me how did you tell me how did you get that in those days? Ooh, girl, tell me. How did you? Bitch ass, Kurt, get in there. Kurt don't want no fucking touchdown. Kurt don't want no touchdown. Which one?
Joseph connects.
I'm saying, like, what's the best Pringles?
It's now 14-0. Now Joseph tees it up to kick off.
Whenever they're around, I catch myself digging a regular drum. So, I don't know. It's even them with the, Oh, wow.
How about this return?
Probably the regular drum.
Gets him across the 30, up to the 33.
Sour cream, I ain't junk, you hear?
The Giants offense at the line, ready to begin their next drive. And they're in a bind early here, down 14-0. Are you worried at this stage or still too early?
You're worried. You're just trying not to transmit it to the rest of your team. You want to make sure that they stay positive. But at the same time, you're wondering, how are we going to move the football? What do we have on this play sheet that can work? Get back to basics is usually your answer. And make sure you find the guy who can move the ball fastest for you if you just get it in his hands.
Yeah, still second quarter, you get points on the board here. You're feeling okay.
And he's missed now his first four passing attempts. The rhythm is just not there to begin this ball game.
Gonna find a plug and everybody get a plea. Then we beg and she. Once he get hit with them rails, he start losing weight. I feel like I'm stuffed. And them bitches wet. How the fuck he makes that dog hit it with the fat? I get him switches to my gang. I'm a team player. Fuck this bitch inside the charger like I'm Edward Bigger. For that cat, I'ma see you later. Fuck that. Two, I'm a real street nigga, man. Fuck that. He a dust pack. Turn exotic side of weed, nigga, with a run set. What's up, Switchy Switchy?
Some cold uptown gas town, too, pal. Going pins with the great brothers.
They'll try and throw for it here.
You can't get a dollar out of me. I don't know what you heard or can't see. I'm a motherfucking PIMP. I'm a motherfucking PIMP. I don't know what you heard about me. I'm a motherfucking VIP. I don't know what you heard about me.
I'm gonna sound into ever say Kobe is better than Magic Johnson, bro. Nigga, Magic Johnson can make a whole 13-man roster successful. I guarantee everybody can average points on teams like nigga. It's crazy.
Do that shit up. A fucking row, boy. Oh, like, why didn't get out the back foot? Oh, my man, Dick. Ah, I seen that shit. That nigga named McFaggy, man. McFaggy. All that dumb shit. Fuck shit.
Ooh, whoop away ass. Yeah, right? And drop the fuck off. Sure, all right.
They got Byron Murphy. I ain't never knew that.
Oh.
that penalty. Boy, they're down only one score. It's still first half. But they're going to line up for their onside kick.
Look at the goodness.
Highlight it.
For the guys covering it, he's been able to stop them deep in their own territory. How about that incredible forward tackle right there?
That's an awesome D-ball.
You ever fuck with Winning Time, the Lakers, John? That's my shit, bro. Look at Darren Waller, we're at 12 now.
Fuck stop, nigga.
Jones, the final shot before break.
Nigga, Mike.
He's gonna let this one go deep.
Nigga got the belt.
So we've hit intermission, it's halftime. This is the NFL, and it's a presentation of the NBA Sports.
In playoff competition, 63, at Boston, he had 56 and 92. Against the Heat, 55, back in Indiana.
The numbers going down.
Against Phoenix.
Team was really smoked in the finals with the fucking Cavs and the Warriors. Oh, that was finals. They was doing some friendly shit.
Cause who was in there last year? Oh, who was the Steve?
Who's the Nuggets?
They were sharing.
Too many offenses want to turn down long drives, but when you're down what they are, they've got to pay it off with some points.
Right.
I believe that.
That's true.
Trying to keep the drive going here. This is play number 7 on 3rd and 2. Operating from the gun, Jones. He'll get this out to Barkley complete. And he will have the Giants first down by about a yard as they're able to convert on 3rd and 2. Now Jones on 1st and 10. And his pass incomplete.
This is something a team that's proven to once a target gets backs to the end defensively. They were aware of that and certainly were prepared on that throw.
Glad to have you with us from Minneapolis. Third quarter.
Well, I already believe that they close that game the toughest game for sure.
Throwing again. Jones. He lets this one fly toward the back of the end zone. And the Vikings are going to get the football here as the ball will come out to the 20.
They were well aware of the scoreboard as they went into halftime, and they know how tough it's been to put up any kind of points. But if there's a positive after that play, is that they were able to take a shot in the end zone.
This nigga can't do nothing.
That shot at 6 ended in an interception, and we know that's not going to jumpstart this struggling offense.
Oh, run game ain't looking like shit.
Which essentially gave him 7 blockers up front. Hard to imagine with all that size and beef that they could let a tackler through. But that's exactly what happened. A loss resulted.
Going up top.
Fucking call, Kurt.
It's a diving catch. A big play there for Minnesota. 62 yards.
Boy, this has just been an offensive clinic. It's seemingly been one big play after another after another. And add this one on to the list. When you combine a whole and half the field on one play, things are definitely working in your favor.
And he'll be taken down at the 20 after a gain of just 1.
You know that old expression, it's not my night? It hasn't been his so far. I don't know if the legs are a little bit heavy. Sometimes having to hang out all day and play doesn't exactly play to your advantage, but it's been a tough go for him.
And every time he looks up, somebody's there defensively. That was the same case on that play. Now a 2nd down throw for the end zone, but it's incomplete. An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on 3rd down. From the shotgun, it's Cousins. And he's got this to Jefferson. Touchdown, Vikings. Kirk Cousins on the connection to Justin Jefferson. And the Vikings have moved out in front by 3 touchdowns.
They had a good lead as they went in at the half, and they came out here in the 2nd half and found a way to extend it. I love their consistency. Don't worry about what they said at halftime. This seemed like a team that's ready to play 60 minutes. And while this game is far from over, I love their approach.
Sure.
Joseph connects on the extra point, and the lead now to 3 touchdowns at 21. Now Joseph tees it up to kick off following the touchdown. From a couple yards deep, he'll bring it out of the end zone. And only able to get this to the 19, so probably should have opted for the touchback. The Giants offense at the line, ready to begin their next drive. I kind of feel like they've reached a do-or-die point in this game, Charles. If they're going to try to pull off an impressive comeback, it has to start right here, right now.
Yeah, now they've got a final chance to get out of this situation, but they also understand they've got to move it fast. In addition, they need to save as much time so they can get two more possessions.
Throwing Jones. And he's going to be intercepted for the third time thus far. Picked off by the linebacker, Jordan Hicks. And he will take this one home. It's a touchdown. And Charles, for this offense, those interception woes that kind of had in the first half have now followed them into the second half. And for this defense, they take advantage.